GitKraken Client version 8.7 is here. With this release, GitKraken Client now supports the ability to create and apply patches. There are three ways to create a patch. First, users may create patches from commits. Right-click on a commit in the graph to access the new option for creating a patch. Click this option and the app will prompt you to select the save location for the patch file. From the graph, you may also use the Shift or Control key to multi-select commits, and then right-click on the selection from here to access the option to create a patch from the selected commits. Second, patches may also be created from the modified files in the working directory. In the commit panel, right-click on an uncommitted file to access the Create Patch from File Changes option. And similar to before, you may use the Shift or Control key to multi-select files before creating the patch. And third, click on the command palette icon on the toolbar or use the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-P to launch the command palette. Here, you may search Patch to access the Create Patch from All Working Directory Changes option. Now that's how you create a patch, but how do you apply them? Patches are applied through the command palette. Type Apply Patch to bring up the Apply Patch command, and select it to open your file explorer. Select the .patch file, and changes will be applied to your working directory. From here, you may continue to modify files, move to stage and commit, or continue with your workflow. Next, users may now customize the left panel by toggling individual sections on or off. Right-click on any section header to check or uncheck sections in the left panel to keep things tidy. A few more things. The new tab view has been reorganized. There are now distinct sections for repository, workspaces, integration, and other app actions. Be sure to try out the integrations. And finally, repository aliases will now carry over when you open a repo in the terminal tab. All right, for full details about all features, improvements, and fixes, please check out the release notes linked in the description. And hey, if this video is helpful, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next release.